And then we pop. We pop after the one. So there's a huge sale on Steam right now. Do they just come up with, like, there's the Lunar New Year sale? And holy smokes, do they have, like, they have deals on everything again. It's the Christmas sale all over again. What am I supposed to do? CeCe Rose. CeCe Rose is up. Is up and looking to shimmy. Five two super solid. Thanks, Cranky. I feel pretty good about it. Flagship for four. Five damage and a draw. We'll take that all day. So I think you got to fish for bigs, don't you? You don't want your opponent to get value at low cost. So we'll scrap out one and we will take the Imperial Frigate. Imperial Frigate for three. Unfortunately, it does get full value. This will be a draw for three. So they have the Spike Pod. What do they get rid of? They should get rid of Machine-Based Defense Center. Get rid of the bigs? Or do they leave those? Do they let those ride? They're going to pop down to four. They can't know that I can't get them, so they should get rid of them. But if they don't, that actually works in their favor. They only scrap the one. Trading post or survey? We're gonna go for cantrip. We're gonna try to keep the cantrips going so that we can get up to some more big cards, big costing cards. They have the shot for four here. We'll see if they leave a machine or the carrier for that matter. Either one we will take, no problem. I like survey at first, but post is a flex appeal and they have to kill it. They do have to kill it, but they also do have the they do have a backdoor potential with blob destroyer on both Spike Pod and the Mech World. So survey, I kind of like survey for the chance for Imperial Frigate and like a discard too, and then we can move into discard if we get enough scrap. So they actually don't get machine, but they'll be able to scrap out either blob carrier or machine base. Hopefully it's blob carrier. If they don't give machine base the credit it deserves, we'll see. We'll see which one they get rid of. Boom. It's not that it doesn't deserve credit, but like, I think that's super good for us. Maybe I'll take this card for three. And maybe I'll take a Blob Destroyer for three. Unable to get rid of the Mech World. So that's kind of unfortunate. But we will be able to get rid of it now. For two as well, we could either Corvette for the cantrip, or we could try like Spike Pod Imperial Fighter. So they're just taking stuff now. They're kind of flooding that low. They're flooding the low B, aren't they? This drops to seven. Play HQ drops to seven. We have two. Take a Corvette, makes sense. Take a Corvette. But 5-2 is sweet. We'll take 5-2. We'll take 5-2. So close yet so far. We're running tradeless. So we're gonna see if you can build a deck tradeless in this scenario. Our opponent has some trade. I'm not sure if that's going to end up So what we're kind of testing if that's worth it or not. Capital World has hit the board. That'll drop down to 7. Oh, they don't want that in the game. They do flip us a cutter. 3 goes down to 2. So now there's two twos. So I think we take both those. I don't think it's gonna be worth it to leave either of those up, and I can't get rid of them. So this way we keep machine base. We get another scrap with it, which is pretty huge. It's a double draw. If we can get Blob Destroyer out, that's just 6 damage before we cycle. They're trying to flip a big. They do flip a big, that's unfortunate for us. So I think the strategy in this to really try to focus on in this arena we could just go mad survivability here. I think that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try to make sure the game goes as long as possible, because we have the advantage the longer the game goes, because they haven't scrapped out anything. I think the strategy is like keeping your eye on the row and always taking damage. Oh wow, again they can't kill machine base. That's so sick. We need to get rid of the Vipers. Is this the time when we send the Imperial out? Do we pop 6 here for like the Blob Worlds? I think a 6 cost Blob World is pretty freaking good, especially when you have some Blob cards. Well, we scrapped out one of them to get there. But I think you keep your eye on the row, and then if you see that the row is all really cheap, try to flip a big guy. You fish the opposite. You want to fish for things that don't, that aren't in your cost range. So that it, like right now, that Mothership will be the only thing that ticks lower. They finally kill that. They could flip that in if they want to. Or are they gonna keep? They're gonna keep Customs Frigate. I don't know if that's necessary. Nothing for 4 cost here. We could scrap out Battle Station. I think that's what we're gonna do. We don't need the survivability at this point. Ship out anything that we don't need, get them as close to death as possible, and then we'll try to push through. Plenty of draw, plenty of damage, plenty of cycle. Get a few. It seems like in this format, snag a few quality cards at a bargain, right? At the grocery outlet. Grocery outlet prices. But your farmer's market quality. So they get plenty of damage, but they don't get any kind of survivability in the form of their bases for authority gain or just stopping damage coming through. So we are gonna take this game here. Nope. The Bilo foods price for the whole foods quantity. There you go. Yes. All right. And we take victory. So we'll take that. We'll take that first one. Helix mode. What's up, Helix mode? Let's go ahead and grab a trade pod. A trade pod, as they are called. Bum, 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 bum. So then five here. We got five scouts. They got five scouts. They get a flagship for five scouts. Awesome. Recycling station drops down to three, though. Everything on the row is three. A three-cost recycling station is going to be hard to pass up. And I think we'll take the cantrip because having the two value is, I think, a little bit better than the explorer. Now, that's a cheap row, though. Holy smokes. They only have three, so they get one, two, and a one. So that's a ram blob fighter or the trade. Ooh. Maybe they should have slowed down for that trade bot. I don't know. We'll ship out two just to get the cycle moving. Scrap there, cargo launch there. Missile bot, all this stuff will stay. We need the scrap advantage. So taking two scrap cards there gives us the advantage. Now we can focus on damage. Now we can focus on damage, survivability. We should be able to last in the long run. Blob carrier drops down to five. We have six though. So I think like battle blob imperial frigate would be better value than taking an almost full cost blob carrier. Now this is interesting. Command ship will pop down to six. We might be able to snag. We'll see. The problem here is we don't have the trade row control. So a full value on War World will be all right, and then we'll see. For five on command ship, they probably have it. Oh wow, that's surprising how much they don't have anything else. Do they get another? Oh my, that's rough. Blob care. Wait, they just bought blob care and they top deck it with no scrap. They top deck it to command ship to the top of the deck. That's a feels bad, man. That is a hardcore feels bad. Holy yikes. $31.45. We'll be able to cycle out a bunch of starters here, which will be pretty good. Command ship's going to be at the top of the deck here for them. Man, that's so intense. They get a free base destruction with it as well. Ugga, ugga, friggin' ugga. This is an ugga game and a half. They have no cards, and we're just going to get destroyed. Jeez. I can't believe they top deck blob carrier there. That is unlucky. Unlucky. So a two cost port of call ain't too bad. We don't want that trade bot right now. That's a great card here. Ship out two. We will take it. Two could go up for three. Two on custom seems all right. Is Battle Blob my is that my front foot forward card? Like, do I need to keep that thing around? I think so. Let's hope they draw poorly. Okay. Well, if there was hope. If there was any kind of hope. That's about what that hope looks like. Let's get another base out here. I think Central would be pretty good here. But Blob Destroyer for four? We'll Central. Central battle 21-14. Two bases out. Maybe Blob Destroyer was the better take. Jeez, maybe Blob Destroyer was the better take. As much as Central Office is so good. So they have a big punch here. which probably takes us out. Imperial to the top. Nothing there we're looking to get rid of. Play the two here. That'll be Corvette out. Three, and I think that's game. 7, 5, and 3, it's game. That is so frustrating. It shows you the power of high quality cards. Like, if you just get some high quality cards and you get them into your deck, oh, it's a loss that feels like we couldn't have done anything about it. I'm sure if we look back into that and we think tanked it, I'm sure we could come up with some stuff that could have been different. But when you take Blob Carrier and there's a command ship out there, and then you top deck Blob Carrier with one of your other two Blob cards on a fresh shuffle, like, there's not much you're gonna be able to do about that. Like, that's just, you know, you move on. Cue another game. Cloud Shaper. One who shapes the clouds. So flagship down to 5. They take patrol. This leaves us in a bit of a kerfuffle there. We'll take the 2. Gives us 5, though. So they'll probably have 4, which doesn't help. Oh. The world is our oyster. If the world is our oyster, what do we take with that oyster? I like drawing cards. And then they're actually going to stay up at 3 because we flipped the battle mech. Huge. We want that trade escort. We'll just go authority. Let's buy Trade Federation stuff. That's always fun. I like buying Trade Federation stuff. That's 2 cost. That's 2 cost. A war world for 2 cost. I want to take Battle Pod, but can I make a war world for 2 cost? Like, holy. Like, what? we'll play yellow blue. We'll go scrapless. We'll let our opponent go into scrap if they want. I think we can beat him with authority gain and damage. Custis, we're gonna embassy out, take the dip here. So they still have 1. Do they flip a big? They do. They flip a big. That's heavy. So 3 for the 4 cost. We'll go 2 on the pod. This will go out here. 3, 38, 43. Ooh, and we have a good chance of actually syncing it up for faction abilities as well. So that's going to be exciting. We'll see if we do, though. It's a whole other issue if we actually can make it happen. I like to think we can, but who knows? Cutter missile here. Doesn't look too bad. They'll probably cutter. They just don't have the authority gain. They're on like the verge of flooding. They aren't. They're like almost there. Let's embassy because we have a couple bases, and I'm gonna let them like take the scrap cards. I don't know if that's a good idea or a bad idea, but they don't have like authority gain besides that one cutter they just took. We can afford to discard a Viper, that's fine. Actually, if we're racing, I think we wanna get rid of that. They go for the damage. That gets us a Capra World at 4 cost. So we will ship out the Viper. Actually, yeah, just in case, we'll ship out Viper. Increase the odds that we do hit what we want to. Capital World, gonna get off Twitch for tonight. Yo, good night, Yarboa. It was great to see you. Cheers. Hope to see you again soon, yo. Interesting. They're making some. Yo, thanks. Dog herbivore. Just crazy. Everything is 1 cost right now. That's so sick. We're gonna take Survey to the top so we get the draw and we hit War Worlds. A ram for one cost. We'll trading post for one cost. We'll send this out. Cutter for two. 1732. We have a lot of authority gain. They've only been able to scrap two, and their authority gain is four from the cutter. So if they're at 21 right now, we're gonna keep soaking with the few bases we have. They're gonna also keep giving us a lot of authority gain. Because every single base not always soaks, but like gives us authority gain. That's pretty nice. We have to send one out. One, two, three, and four. We can send out the Viper just to ensure that we have the four to take one of these. More authority gain. Let's get rid of the missile for the five. Four for Destroyer. 13 damage, 8 to 43. We get the cantrip on Capital World, which also soaks quite a bit. We'll see what they get here. Hopefully they get a really big hand. I actually want them to hit a big combo. Patrol, battle, both patrols, battle, two missiles. Nope. So that means they're going to be able to kill this. If we draw into damage, any damage at all, we win. Okay. We win. Huzzah!
I think you're great.
CC friggin' Kinnison, dude. 20 months? Are you even on the for real with me right now, dude? CC Kinnison, man! Yeah! Foom indeed! How you doing? What's up, Kinnison? Yo, seriously, man. Thank you so much. That's like super, that's super nice of you. Tier 2. This is what it tells me the moment I get home. What, that you're nuts? Yo, cheers, dude. Seriously, that's super nice of you, man. 20 months, that's like, that's some insane amount of support. I really appreciate it. You've been there ever since the beginning. Ever since the beginning, man. So what's going on in the life of Kinnison? 1-1 and then 2? I think so. We'll let these bigs keep chipping down. We got two scrap. We bought the same thing twice. So we'll see how that works out. A three cost death world, I think, is kind of suicidal to keep ignoring. Maybe that's just me. But even with a cutter out there, like, a death world has astronomically more value. Not much, literally just got into the house home from Vegas. Oh, gotcha! That's right, I forgot that you were in Vegas. How was it? How was Vegas? They did not take all of the money I took there to lose. Hey, that's winning. I think we call that winning. Five for Royal Redoubt, and then we'll ship. We bought him a scrap. We might have some draw. Death World, or I'm sorry, Brain World for 8. So they end up paying 8, even though it only costs 7. But that's still a pretty tough spot for us, all things considered. We have two bases. Let's take here, and then we'll take another base. 2 costs for a 5. Bum, 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 bum. Sorry I was bouncing back and forth. Bouncing back and forth from what? No need to apologize. Great to see you. Hope you're doing well. What's up, Sonny? This and MTG Arena. Oh, gotcha. Gotcha. Sarah would be the one to talk to about that. I don't do much with magic. This game is going to be very, very frustrating because Brain World has stayed out far past its bedtime. But at least we do have some stuff to grab with. Let's get some scrap cards out here. We need to scrap with this first for the draw. But what do we scrap? I think with this one, we take a Federation Shuttle and we scrap that Federation Shuttle. Because I don't want to scrap any other things right now. That's another draw. Pop up here for two on the draw. 10 through 51 to 40. But now we have a really nice setup if they don't get the things they need. Had fun, hit one small jackpot, which I obviously gave back. Came within one card of winning 400G. No, not kidding. Four or six of spades. Dealer had the six, player to the left of me had the four. Yo. Kinnison, that's insane. Holy. What's the arena type thingy? So the arena type thingy this time is at the end of each player's turn, the cost of the most expensive card or cards in the trade row is reduced by one. I think we can wall them out. I think we hive because it's a cantrip for draw. Two on patrol, so we're paying two here because I want to keep the Corvette because it's a cantrip. Get him on the discard, get him on the discard. This can be a save up on one. Get rid of this, 55, 44. We can just keep trying to cycle the bases as much as possible at least. So with that double, they get eight. They can't get through, they can get through two, but then we play another one. And then we're just gonna keep buying. We're just gonna keep doing this. Death World, I think, has a lot of value here because cards get cheaper. Heroin Edge, because the rest of the table would have gotten at least a grand a piece in envy bonus. Ah. So how do you set up? Was that just like a jackpot? Like you need to hit a very specific hand and fortune was on your side to get that close? Or is that just the stakes? Are you a high roller and you didn't mention it? This game is pretty insane. Blob Destroyer, I think I have to take that card. That's an excellent card to come up for us. We get to pay one for a scrap. Scrap and a draw. There's a draw. There's a double discard, which is huge. 46, 47. So far, we're playing the Death World really well. The Death World is really coming in clutch. Seven card, straight flush. Plus, we bay in the progressive payout in the Caesar's Chain. MGM doesn't have the progressive. Best you could win there would have been about 75,000 for the same hand. Gotcha. So a seven card straight flush, not a five card, a seven card. It's insane. So they copy there for the double discard. Do they have two to actually scrap out? So they scrap out the one. That's kind of weird. The bike is not going to be what they want here. They should scrap out a battlecruiser to get rid of the base, to get rid of the six. You make two hands, one is two cards and the other is five. Ah, gotcha. I haven't played Paigo. Sounds interesting though. I may need to, maybe I need to give it a shot. It sounds interesting. I've only ever played I've played a lot of different, I haven't played like, I don't know, the Paigao, that sounds like a casino game, specifically. Did they just leave Death World? I don't understand some people. Why would you leave Death World? I'm only familiar with poker otherwise. I don't know. I don't know if that makes any sense. Let's take port a call for three. And then we'll take recycling station for three. 45 to 46. We're keeping the scrap. We're keeping the cycle. I mean, it's crazy. I really liked Omaha High Low. Really like Omaha High Low as far as like a poker game is concerned. So they get five, but once again, I mean, we're cruising on this. We get to scrap out something. So we should use this first. Scrap out our one cost here to get our draw. Perfect. Whoops. Another draw. Boom. That's the double. We go here. I think we just heal up there. Flea HQ can get out of here. Bases are neat, team. Bases are neat. Man, I can't. This is a feel good game. Casino game, you can push a lot with the house, make their money with all the side bets. The house makes their money on the VIG. Ah. Mmm. So they get a decent hand here, but they have so much work to do to get through all this stuff, and they really don't have damage. They just sacked out the battlecruiser again. They have Stealth Needle. Like, I'm just gonna keep drawing everything, right? They can't get me on discards anymore. I think this gives us a really good shot at this game. They can't get us on discards. Stealth Needle right now doesn't have a faction partner. So we want to take this, and we want to draw two first, and then we'll ship out two with the bike. Like so. And then we're gonna go ahead and draw out the protocol. That's unlucky. Well, I'm not interested in letting any of that live. Great hand coming up, though. We just need to get more, we need to get more discards synced up. Junkyard scraps one. So they copy with, wait, is that a copy with Stealth Needle? Oh, no, never mind. Jeez. Well, I don't want any of those, unfortunately. I really want discard. I'm gonna take this to the top. Then we'll draw it. Give us a scrap because I want the trade. We're gonna take missile and scrap that out to get a draw here. Then we'll get a draw here. Draw there. We'll scrap this out for a draw. $18 to $50. I'm gonna take this down into discard because the Death World might live here. This is intense. Do you know when Frontier will hit the app? I wish I knew. The sooner the better. I think Frontiers is the best core set. Like, I think it's the, oh, it's just so much fun. I love the play. I love bases. I adore bases and Frontiers. Oh, it's so good. This game is insane. This game is actually insane. What a match. I mean, we've got game here, right? So we can cycle these two out. We can use the supply scrap here. Didn't hit the draw there. But that's a faction. Scrap that out. We have the five. This gets rid of there. Pop for five here. Holy. Man. What a game. That game was insane. All that, just the word 3-1 right now. That's so crazy. I just 4-0'd Cliff and Admirals. Dude, sick. Congrats. What format were we, do you remember the formats of the games? If I remember right, they like to, Cliff likes to play more, like, minimalist formats, and you tend to play more not minimalist formats. Not that it really ended up mattering in a 4-0. Nice work, man. So we have to take Spike. Why don't we just go ahead and stay in blob here against Elishar. Elishar? Cliff is MPMP. Oh, okay. I think defense center is worth this early. I don't mind that. I don't mind a two here. Oh, that's a decent start. Not having scrap kind of sucks. Once again, I think Death World is a strong card. I think people are maybe underestimating Death World a little bit. I don't know. First two mine from missing four on my list, last two his. I think this game's a loss, unfortunately. They bottom deck a scrap card, so that's pretty good. And now we actually get an answer for a scrap card. Actually, I might even just give them that scrap card. I think I'm a crazy person. I've actually been neglecting scrap and it's been working? Question mark? Well, in some games. Unfortunately, we do have the three cost bike here, but it does have to go into discard. It's kind of unfortunate. We're gonna keep taking the cheaps and scrapping them out for draws because we're savages. We'll take the battle cruiser. We'll do the damage. Two bases up, 38, 37. Let's see if Death World holds what we what the kind of weight that we were hoping it would. Sorry that I'm a little distracted right there, guys. Just So I think we need the draw first. But what's the cheap that we want to scrap out? Is it Survey? Is it Tradebot? Do we sacrifice the Tradebots to the altar? Let's see what happens if we do. Well, that's a good start. Get rid of the other scrap cards that are out there. We pop up for four. Hit for 11, two bases up. Battlecruiser might be enough to push through. They don't have authority gain. They do have authority gain, sorry, with Federation Shuttle and the Defense Center. Non-mixed gambits. There were some Mega Hauling in one game, some Blob Bot Beats, all fun things. Rock and roll. I think you adapt well to very adapt requiring formats. So we get Dreadnought. We could sacrifice something to the gods, or we could let that stand. Let's sacrifice to the gods. I like our choice. We aren't gonna use the bike here. This is crazy. We actually went scrapless on this. Maybe, or they just fit me. I wasn't looking at the formats while playing, but I guess there was some similarity in those first three. My point is that I wasn't looking at the formats while playing. That statement alone leads me to reaffirm, or just rather affirm, I guess, what I said. And that is that I think you do really well in formats that require adaptation. Because you're able to analyze and look at the row and make good decisions based on your analysis. We need to buy something here so we can draw. I can't believe we just won this game. We're actually a crazy person. Holy. Wow. We're actually doing pretty well in this. So 4-1, do we have time for, yeah, we got time. Let's go. So we have Igor Bad. This is somebody we've run into before. We'll take the Stealth Needle and a Trade Bot. That's going to be a great start for us. Should be able to push us through. I like that. I like that opening quite a bit. I think Stealth Needle is super strong. Imam would love Stealth Needle, or she would love this arena rather, if she's not already chipping away at it. Custom's Frigate might get a little bit of a boost as well. Let's take the Blob Destroyer because they took a base. Freighter goes down to 3. The whole row's 3. And we have 3. How convenient. So everything drops down to 2. What's the best value? Frigate? I think frigate because we have the stealth needle. I think she won already at the foil is what she spilled to me. Oh, gotcha. Fair enough. Hmm. Everything's 1 cost. We take 3 survey ships for 1 cost and a cutter for 1 cost. That just happened. That's real life. That's real life right there. Holy. Okay. We'll have 4 to get rid of to get through at least the space station. I like customs when you keep your expectations low. I mean, assuming, you know, that cards do stay up there and do like kind of creep down lower, customs forget should get at least a noticeable boost in value, since it's theoretically going to have more targets more often. We will select none, and we will take the bike. I think, if anything, too, we've won 3 games now, consciously avoiding scrap, which seems pretty nuts. Hey, Bubba, what's up? Bubba Boo, you being a Bubba? We'll take whichever one they don't. Oh, actually, there's a lot of this stuff. If it could be huge here, if Mothership or something ends up a 4, it's true. Unfortunately, we didn't draw it. And they're gonna have some big swings here. They go machine base, so they're trying to base us out. Interesting. I like going the battlecruiser route then. They go up for 2, grab for 1. They have a ton of bases. Maybe Mothership would be better. Just to take as much draw as possible, but then we give them the battleship. Battleship hits with War World and Space Station. Blobfighter hits Mothership. I think Battlecruiser is the card that we want them to have less. Unfortunately, we can't get rid of the other. So the double draw could be huge though. Drawing 4 cards. They're gonna have 8. I'm just wondering if the discards are good enough, because they just have bases, and Battlecruiser for the end of the game would be a little bit better. The faction draw, 2 factions for it. I just like making them discard. I'm gonna go with my gut on this. I'm just going with my gut. I think Mothership does have some great value. Ooh, do they Capital World? Do they Capital World and leave us Mothership? Cranky, you're a prophet. The fact that we just custom, see, this is, that's what we're looking at. That's the craziness right there. We could hit him with a triple right now too. Better to keep these around though for our faction, because we cantrip value just on Battlecruiser. It's a discard for free. We don't need scrap right now, so I don't think we need to actually take anything else. We could actually cycle all this over to the other side. We could take a draw here. I think that'd be a mistake after playing all these scouts. I could have taken the draw with these scouts still up in case I got the bike. But I think because I made the... I'd be exacerbating an issue there by... So I think the draw would have been the right play. Unfortunately, we wouldn't have Mothership, but I think it was the right play. Excuse me. They're super soft War Worlds. You're right. War World is their only damage, which is pretty crazy. So flagship drops down to 4 here. That's pretty huge. We don't need the bases. Oh, you actually think you would have kept it? I think I'm thinking too much of like hitting the luck backs, right? Not bad. Not bad there. This is not a bad situation at all. Their discard is 0. They can't make us discard cards. They can cycle a lot, but I think our damage is pretty sick. Stealthy Needle right now is looking, it's gonna have a target no matter what. That's super exciting. You have some scouts in there to wheel over, but the motion and other draw cards are worth shuffling. True, true. So there's the damage out for War Worlds. Unless we get savagely unlucky, this could be a very big combo for us and could set them up for disaster. Let's find out if that is exactly what happens. A double bike. We could even double bike because we have enough fodder. They can't do anything else. I don't know what they're waiting for. Probably just a lag. Cool. Well, we didn't get savagely unlucky. That's pretty disgusting. Wow, why not? Let's take out this and let's see what we drop. If we can drop like a, that's pretty nice. We only have the 2 bases. If we take another bike though, then that one could end up being great for us. So let's take the other bike. Let's take the embassy. Because I'm not sure. I'm gonna let that sit. Let's hit him with the discard. Play here. Now we have a chance with 2 bases, and this one likely staying alive unless they get rid of Battle Station, it looks like. That's, wow, what a bad, are you kidding me? They bottom decked everything. Yikes. Okay. We have no damage here. We have to draw into it. But why don't we just do that? Why don't we just draw into it? Worst case scenario, we're going to get them on a double discard and all this goodness. Maybe even a triple discard if we get lucky. A triple discard would be game, though. Unlucky. Double discard, still savage. We should be able to close this out. Battle cruiser pops straight through. Customs frigate can do customs frigate things. We select none and we just draw. Perfect. That's game. Living the dream, ladies and gentlemen. Buy shuttle to fish. Hmm. Well, whatever the buy shuttle to fish was, I think I totally missed that opportunity. But hey, here we are going for the big boom. And this will actually close up the stream too after this game's done. So let's see if we can close up the stream with a bang. With a bang. So far, what I've noticed is we've neglected scrap and come out victorious, being able to focus on base walls, using the idea that you get high quality cards at a much faster rate, and high quality cards trump scrap, right? Because scrap cards aren't expensive. Brain World is the most expensive one, but notably, like, the cards are 5-4-3 or 5-4-2-1. 5-4-3-2-1, right. Those cards being cheap means that their value is, like, consistent with that cost value. Versus getting high-quality cards that hit, that draw, that give great faction opportunity. And that's exactly what we seem to be driving home here. I think every game that I've taken like a card, like a scrap card first, I think I've lost. We may have to check that on the tape later, but I think every single time I've taken a scrap card up front, I've lost the game. We have the scrap. I think going base is just too good. I think that's it. I'm actually going to take the shuttle. The shuttle is going to hit with Customs Frigate and Freighter if they don't decide to do that. Everything's cost two out here. They go Freighter. Customs. Cargo. We get Battle Mech. Sick. It's actually dope. And now we can... Now, I didn't want to take this Federation shuttle anymore, but it's here. But now we can just go into Star Empire. No problem. They'll probably take two Imperial Frigates here. I'd be surprised if they didn't. They got zero stars, so... Do they go missile and then leave me an Imperial Frigate? That'd be nice. Ooh, Border Fort instead, though. Border Fort for three. We get both, actually. Don't even have to worry about it. Take out the Viper. We'll go Border. You know what? I think I'm actually gonna take the Battle Station. That's like a crazy thing. That's a crazy thing right there. That's a mix-up. That's a mix-up and a half, taking that battle station. Because I'm giving them the missile bot, but I have the scrap. Like, we're good. We're out. We've checked out. Now we got to go fast. They got heals. Base could help. They don't have heals. But we have scrap and bases, and they're going, it looks like, kind of... front, like, assault up front. I don't really know how else to say it. Two for trade pod? Or is that too passive? I like it for the hive. Wait, I'm so dumb. That should have been two damage. I'm gonna scrap with it and then I end up taking the trade. That's two damage out. I make these mistakes all the time on stream. I feel like I don't make them near as much when I'm not streaming. Ugh, it's just so frustrating. I wish I could play it like full, like 100% on stream. And sometimes that like Bax shows up and like really puts it together. And it's always really exciting for me and everybody involved. But man, does it suck making those little like chip chop like mistakes every once in a while. Or often, one way or another. So Blob World goes down to five. That's insane. That's great for us. So 34-47. We have a ton of bases. We have a ton of scrap. Like, I think we've played this really well. And I think Battle Station was a really savage and clever play for us. Their damage is low besides these frigates. They get us on a double, which is fine. We will definitely cut her. And we're going to leave that base up. Another double scrap. They have us on discard, so that could come back to haunt us a little bit. My dogs might start barking. Those frigates, though, it's true, but they just flooded like a crazy person. Holy flood. We'll take embassy. This time I won't mess that up. Actually, I could have just scrapped from here. I messed it up anyway. Actually, I didn't mess it up. I did mess it up. A one cost freighter? I don't know. Is one cost freighter too fluffy? I wonder if a one cost freighter at this stage is too fluffy. Our bases are sick though. Blobboard probably for damage. I'm on my last game and then I'm good. 35-23. I think we can get the 6-1. They hit the discard on us, but like we have these bases up. And that's pretty good. Can we draw into blue and then get battlecruiser? Do we go for that? What's the order here? We have quite a bit of damage. I think our goal here is just to go for the win. And I think we do that by playing these two, taking battlecruiser, doing damage, scrapping the scout we had to discard here, going five, scrap out top two bigs, try to leave them with nothing, scrap this out, keep base up for the embassy yacht connection. And then they just don't have the big punch. Man, I really like the way we played this game. They're going to hit us on a big discard, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. If they get us on a triple, we'll just send all the we'll send all three of the blues out. Because in the event that we draw the 50%, because that also gives us double scrap. The three wins the game. 50% chance to win the game now. Let's think about this real quick, though. Just real quick. Take a second. Nah, I think we go for the win.